bad dreams, huh? Well, it is real, sort of. You see, part of being a Grey Warden is being able to hear the Darkspawn. That's what your dream was, hearing them. The Archdemon, it talks to the Horde, and we feel it just as they do. That's why we know this is really a blight. It takes a bit, but eventually you can block the dreams out. Some of the older Grey Wardens say they can understand the Archdemon a bit, but I sure can't. Anyhow, when I heard you thrashing around, I thought I should tell you. It was scary at first for you too. Other than dying young and the whole defeat the Blight alone thing, no, I'm all tapped out for surprises. Anyhow, you're up now, right? Let's pull up camp and get a move on.
Ah, it's good to see you, my timely rescuer. Bodon Fennec, at your service once again. I saw your camp and thought to myself, what safer place to rest for the evening than in the camp of a Grey Warden? I'm perfectly willing to offer you a fine discount for the inconvenience of our presence. How does that sound? Good? Yes? I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
Hello.
The boy's a bit simple, but he's rather good with enchantments. One of those tranquil fellas actually called him a... what was it now? A savant. I had no idea such a thing existed. He can fold lyrium into almost any weapon or piece of armor, though naturally some of the more extravagant materials will take more lyrium than others. It's a process that some of the master smiths back in Orzammar will perform, but my boy here is just as adept at it. Isn't that right, boy?
Enchantment!
And there you have it.
Why are we stopping? There are darkspawn to be fought. Is this delay needful? You are concerned. No need. I am fit enough to fight. I am. I have always fought in war, human. My people have been at war since the moment we set foot in the Northern Islands. We do now. Somewhere else. No. I was born in Saharon. Of the land we came from, I know nothing, not even its name. I do not see how this matters. Saharon and Parvolan are distant. Ferelden and the Darkspawn are immediate. As you wish.
What do you wish of me? If you must. I was not born such. 'Tis a skill of Flemeth's, taught over many years in the wilds. The chastened have tales of we witches, saying that we assume the forms of creatures to watch them from hiding. When a child is alone and separate from his tribe, that is when we strike, dragging the young boy kicking and screaming to our lair to be devoured. A most amusing legend. Changing her form, certainly. Devouring lost children, I cannot say. She has not done it in my experience, though in truth my lifespan is but a fraction of her own. Why do you ask? Is there something specific you wish to know? The form of an animal is different from my own. One may study the creature, learn to move as it does, think as it does. In time, this allows one to become as it is. I gain nothing by studying another human. I already am the same as they are. I learn nothing. So the answer is no, my human form is the only one I possess. There were nights when the wilds called to me, 'tis true. You look upon the world around you and you think you know it well. I have smelled it as a wolf, listened as a cat, prowled shadows that you never dreamed existed. But my life is as a human. I am under no illusions to the contrary. Anyone with sufficient will. But the act of transformation is a magical one. 'Tis a spell and thus requires a mage's talents. Indeed, you could learn the spells required if I cared to teach you. Indeed. Have you an opinion on my abilities, then? Am I an unnatural abomination to be put to the torch? A most practical opinion. Far more so than any man I have spoken to. But enough of such talk, let us proceed lest the dust gather on us.
Yes? Well, here I am. I knew this would come up sooner or later. I don't know how to explain, but I had a dream. In it, there was an impenetrable darkness. It was so dense, so real. And there was a noise, a terrible, ungodly noise. I stood on a peak and watched as the darkness consumed everything. And when the storm swallowed the last of the sun's light, I fell, and the darkness drew me in. I suppose I did. That was what the darkness was, no? When I woke, I went to the Chantry's gardens, as I always do. But that day, the rose bush in the corner had flowered. Everyone knew that bush was dead. It was grey and twisted and gnarled, the ugliest thing you ever saw. But there it was, a single beautiful rose. It was as though the Maker stretched out his hand to say, even in the midst of this darkness, there is hope and beauty. Have faith. No, not voices. It's not so simple. He spoke directly to my soul, in a language no human tongue can express. There are so many good things in the Maker's world. How can I sit by while the Blight devours everything? He's still here. I hear him in the wind and the waves. I feel him in the sunlight that warms my skin. I know what the Chantry says about the Maker, and what should I believe? What I feel in my heart, or what others tell me? Thank you. It's nice to find someone who agrees. I know what I know, and no one will ever make that untrue.